In this video, we'll show you how to update your ASUS motherboard using the EasyFlash 3 method, which requires you to boot into the BIOS. We do have a video on how to use the BIOS flashback method as well, which can be done on a motherboard with no components installed. See the link in the info card above for that video. If your motherboard needs an update for newer CPU support, you may need to do it with that method if your motherboard supports the BIOS flashback method. Some important tips while doing this. If you have any issues with updating, the most common issue is usually the USB drive, and that may not be supported by the motherboard. Try a different one if any issues, they can be really picky. USB must be under 32 gigabytes so it can be formatted with the FAT32 file system. The most common key to enter the BIOS is the delete key. Always read the BIOS update notes so you are aware of any important information, and it is usually only recommended to update your BIOS if you are having issues or if there is a security reason. BIOS settings will be reset when updated, so be sure to make note of any custom settings so you can set those back after the update. The first step is to format your USB drive. It must be under 32 gigabytes in order for Windows to be able to format as the FAT32 file system. I always recommend only having the USB you are formatting inserted into your computer so you don't format the wrong one. After inserting your USB drive, navigate to it and right-click on the drive and select Format from the menu. Once the format dialog comes up, make sure FAT32 is selected in the file system options. This will not work with any other file system. Usually, all other default options are fine. Then click on Start, then click on OK when the warning dialog comes up. It will then format the drive, and when done, click OK. At this point, we can close the format dialog, and we can now go to download the BIOS update. Now we will navigate to the support page for your motherboard and go to the BIOS and firmware section. The most recent updates are listed at the top. In most cases, you'll want the latest one. And don't forget to read the details in case there is important information about the update. Download the update file, and the easiest place to save the file is on the USB drive you just formatted. Once the file is downloaded, navigate to the USB drive where you saved it. Then right-click on the zip file and select Extract All. To make things easier, I always delete everything after the backslash so it extracts directly to the top-level root directory. Once the zip file is extracted, I usually delete all but the BIOS update file, which should have a .cap extension. For this method, you do not rename the file, so there is no need for the renamer file either. At this point, we are ready to update the BIOS. If you're updating the BIOS on the computer you are using, then you can just restart your computer. Otherwise, now you can safely eject your USB drive and insert it into the computer to be updated. To enter the BIOS, the most common key to press during boot is the delete key. Ours also supports using the F2, and there are sometimes others. When you enter the BIOS, you may be in the easy mode. You'll need to switch to advanced mode to find the BIOS update tool. As you can see here, our current BIOS version is 16.01, and we will be updating to 17.01. Now go to the tool menu, and you should find the ASUS EasyFlash 3 utility. After clicking on it, you should see the BIOS update interface and the USB drive listed on the left. On the right, you will see the update file, which we will now click on. If using BitLocker, please follow the warning instructions before updating. Click on Yes to proceed. When it asks if you want to read the file, select Yes. Then click on Yes again when it asks if you are sure you want to update the BIOS. At this point, the update will start and will probably take a couple minutes. This video has been sped up. And just a reminder, if you have any issues with the update, always try a different USB as your first step. These motherboards are very picky and can be very sensitive. I've had USBs that work in one and not another. Once the update is complete, the system will restart and will enter the BIOS again to verify the update was successful by checking the BIOS version. And do remember, you will need to update your settings if you had any custom settings from before. As you can see here, the update was successful, and we have the most recent update installed. Thanks for watching, and if you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing so we can make more.